I'm Jennifer Smart, and we're here at the El Capitan Theater in Hollywood for the world premiere of Secretariat. Based on a true story, it's about Triple Crown winner and his owner, Penny Chenery, and how they both beat the odds. What is the best way to train a horse?
Kindness.
What kind of treats do horses train best for?
We don't use treats. We just, reinforce good behavior and we're not so good with the bad behavior.
Some of my friends have horses and they pet them and give them hay and everything. Is there anything special you have to do for thoroughbreds other than like hobby horses?
You just have to understand their nature and what they're bred to do is they have a lot of energy, so you just have to accept that and it's part of who they are.
Tell us about your character John in Secretariat.
He's just like the younger brother. He's just kind of like out of it, I guess. I mean, that's the only word I can really think of, but yeah.
Did you get to work with the horse that played Secretariat?
I was around him a couple times, and it was interesting. I loved it, but yeah.
What was the most interesting thing that happened around the horse?
Just how calm he was. I expected him to be more like wanting to move, but he was calm.
Is it true that horses have different personalities, so you have to ride them differently?
Every single horse has a different personality. Some don't like to wake up early. Some don't like to eat certain foods. Some don't like certain jockeys. Some don't like certain grooms. And the thing I've found, when you can get their favorite food in front of them, their favorite groom, and their favorite jockey, then they will usually do what you want them to do, and they'll do it in a fast way.
What made you want to become a jockey?
Secretariat. I was 11 years old when I saw Secretariat run in the Belmont Stakes. I'd actually watched him on TV run a couple of times, and when I saw him win the Belmont Stakes by something like 32 lengths, I watched on a black and white TV. That's how old I am. And I fell in love with horse racing. I'm from horse racing. My mom and dad are involved in horse racing, have been since I was a kid, but it was Secretariat that made me fall in love with it.
What is the scariest thing about riding a horse in a high-speed race?
Anything can happen at 45 miles an hour, and you're dealing not only with other competitors that are jockeys, but other animals and athletes. And if there's an accident in front of you, there's very little that you can do. You don't have a roll cage, you don't have a seat belt, and all you have is a helmet and your instincts to take care of you, and hopefully the horse is taking care of you a little bit too.
Are you ever concerned that when a book is made into a movie that the message will be lost?
No, in this particular case I wasn't. I had read the screenplay, and I thought that the screenplay that I read originally was very good, and it was spot on in terms of accuracy, and I thought it brought the right touch of reverence to the subject, and the message being that about Penny Chenery, Penny Tweedy, at the time had become pulled into her father's horse business because he was sick and he couldn't do it anymore, and so she rushed into the vacuum that his illness created. So she was toggling back and forth between her home in Denver with her children, and her and the horse business out in the East Coast. And trying to run both things, and it was very difficult, caused a lot of tensions, which will come out in the movie. And so it was very accurate in that sense. The message is very clear, and it's an empowering message for women, that you can do it. You can get out there in the man's world and succeed.
What inspired you to write about Secretariat?
I spent a lot of time around him. When I met him, when he was a young, untrained, untested two-year-old, and I was an untested turf rider, and so we came on the racetrack about the same time. I saw him run his first race. I'd met him a month earlier. I saw him run his first race, then I saw him run his second race, then he took off at Saratoga, and he became a superstar. And I had all these notebooks filled with stuff, and I originally wanted to do a magazine story, but it turned into a book because he turned into a book.
What inspired you to become a jockey?
All my life I dreamed of becoming a professional athlete. And at 5 foot tall and 110 pounds, jockey was about the only thing out there that I could compete in.
Is it true that horses have different personalities, so they have to be ridden differently?
Every horse has a different, they're just like all these people here. Every one of them has their things that they like and don't like, and that's our job to figure out what that is.
What is the scariest thing about riding in a high-speed race?
The scariest thing is just the possibility of going down in a race. I mean, uncertain, you know, unfortunate things happen. Horses break legs, or, you know, just you clip hills and horses, you know, there are accidents. And going down on a horse going 40 miles an hour, it weighs 1,200 pounds landing on top of you, not to mention all the hooves of the other horses running, you know. I mean, it's very scary, but you don't think about it.
Are there any charities you find important to support?
As far as charities, there's a Center for Women in Racing, and that's probably the one I support the most.
Tell us about your character, Chris, in Secretariat.
Well, he plays Diane Lane's son, which plays Penny Shinnery, and he is a cool guy. He picks on his little brother a little bit, but he's a cool guy.
Did you get to work with the horses at all?
A little bit, not really. No real interaction. I got to pet its nose a little bit, but that's about it. So.
Do you have a favorite scene in the movie?
Probably one of the races. The races were cool. They just sent tingles up my spine. So.
What other projects are you working on?
I will be seen in Jeffrey Dean Morgan in the Fields and Chloe Grace Moretz.
Tell us about your character in Secretariat.
Well, my character is Hollis Chenery, and he's Penny Chenery's brother. And we basically are the children of the guy who had the farm that Secretariat came from. When he became somewhat feeble, Penny and I were faced with a situation where I said, let's sell it. Let's get rid of these horses, get as much money as we can, especially that one that you like so much. And once we get some money for it, we'll be able to, you know, settle up. And she said, no, I think I'm going to take over this horse situation, the horse, what do you call it, horse farm? I don't know what you call it. And I'm from Wall Street, what do I know? And she was able to step forward and bring to us Secretariat, one of the most inspirational stories in sports ever told.
Do you have a lot of experience with horses?
Only through my daughter, Willa. She rides as much as she can. Almost every summer she goes to a horse farm and spends all day mucking out the stalls and riding. So I get my horse contact through her.
Tell us about the story of Secretariat.
Well, Secretariat was the greatest racehorse that ever lived. You know, Triple Crown winner, one of the greatest athletes, human or not, you know, animal, to ever come. And really, but the incredible part of the story is Penny Chenery's journey, and that's why we made the movie, because she was a housewife living in Denver and came in to take over this farm. And, you know, that's always fun to watch, you know, this fish out of water and watch someone really kind of come into their own when all the odds are against them. So it's really inspirational.
What were the challenges of making this movie?
You know, I think, you know, we tried to make this for a price, and we really were had to be very nimble and very, you know, smart with how we shot the film. And we shot it in only 45 days, and that's really quick for a movie, especially something with horse racing and everything like that. So it was really a challenge to make the movie, but it made it a better movie, I think, because we really worked hard.
Tell us about your character in Secretariat.
I play Elizabeth Hamm. She's the assistant to Chris Chenery, Penny Chenery's father. And when he dies, he leaves me part of the horse, and I name the horse, and we, and then I support Penny and her endeavor.
Do you have a lot of experience with horses?
I do. I grew up with horses. I rode my first horse when I was 5 months old with the help of my father. Enter our next door neighbor's kitchen.